Okay, today we talk about the fundamental of electric circuit. So the content is in the chapter 2 of our early friend books. Okay, but I skipped some section of this chapter. Okay, just remind you some fundamental concept of electric circuit, right? And just to make some agreement when we make a discussion. So what is the branch, what is the node, and what is current flow, which direction is positive and which direction is negative, right? And then we talk about some laws about the Kirchhoff laws, right? And at the end of this lecture, I will introduce you some measuring circuit concept called Wheatstone bridge, that is very well known circuit used in the industrial. Okay, for the learning objective of this presentation is first, I would like you to know about the definition of node, loop, and mesh and branch, and the concept of voltage and current source. That in fact, I has talked about the voltage and current source last time, right? And then I will talk about the Kirchhoff law. I think you learned some in physics, right? And then we will talk about the passive sign convention. So the sign of the current, right? Current is, for example, I1, which direction is positive and which direction is negative, the voltage also, right? And then I will introduce you about the voltage and current divider laws, right? Voltage and current divider law, and this is a really a useful concept when you analyze the circuit later on. Okay. And then at the end of this lecture, I will introduce some measuring instrument of electric circuit, right? Some circuit, some well-known circuit used in measuring in industrial measurement and instrumentation, or in this is the circuit connected with the sensor, right, in the industrial. Okay, we start with the definition of branch, node, loop, and mesh, and the ideal source, voltage source, and current source. Okay, and the ideal voltage source is the source that provides a prescribed voltage across its terminal, irrespective of the current flow through it. It means that the voltage is always constant, right? Always constant. Okay, and we can also call this type of voltage as independent source, right? It's not depending on the current flow. It can supply any current. It's depend on the circuit connected to the source, right? And the current will flow in accordance to this circuit, but the voltage will never change in this case. And the ideal voltage source can be both DC and AC source, right? And this is an example of a voltage source in practice, but in practice it's not always constant. When you when the source supply more current, usually the voltage is become lower than its original voltage, right? The example is the battery for DC source, and the generator or alternator or dynamo for AC generation. This is DC and this is AC generation. Okay. This is a symbolic circuit, right? In practice, the source may have the internal resistance when you connect the load to the source. The voltage at the terminal is lower than the voltage when the circuit is open. Okay. Okay, similarly for the ideal current source, the ideal current source is the source that provides prescribed current to any circuit connected to it. And the voltage generated by the source is determined by the circuit connected to it, right? We can compute the voltage across the circuit. This is the circuit across the source also in this case. But the current supply from this source will never change. Okay. And the constant current source, usually you found it in the laboratory. Okay. It's not the in your very rare current source in real life or in practice, right? Usually you use it in the industrial, in some electronic circuit, right? Because in our common life, we use the constant voltage source mostly. And we connect the load to this type of source in parallel circuit. Okay, we also have the dependent source or controlled source. This kind of source can be both voltage and current, and we can have four types of this dependent source, including voltage controlled voltage source. Voltage controlled, it means the voltage source that controlled by the voltage, okay, from somewhere else. So the voltage of this source is equal to the constant value into the voltage from somewhere else in the circuit. We control this voltage by, we can control Vs by varying Vx, okay. If Vx is varying, Vs is changed, it's not constant, it depends on the voltage from us some other part of the circuit. Or we can have current controlled voltage source. So this type of voltage source is controlled by the current from somewhere, right? The Vs is the constant into Ix, okay, from the current. We can do this, the Vs is depending on Ix, in fact. And we also have voltage controlled current source. It's a current source. This is the current source, but it's controlled by voltage source. Okay, or voltage from somewhere. Okay, this current is the constant into Vx. And lastly, is the current controlled current source. This is the current source, but it's depending on the current from some other place in the circuit. Okay. But usually I don't touch to the control source. So let's see later if we can have this type of circuit, for example, when we make a circuit analysis. Okay, now let's come to the definition of branch, node, and mesh and loop. Okay, the branch is the portion of the circuit with two terminals connected to it. Okay, this is a branch. The branch may be includes the resistance or the battery or the source or the metering, for example. And in practice, any circuit element with two terminals connected to it is the branch. Okay, so we call the element in between two nodes, right? We call this part as a branch of the circuit. Okay, now come to the definition of node. Node is the junction of two or more branch. Okay, if two branch connect together, we can call it as the node, or maybe three or four, five branch, or more than two, we can call it as branch. And in effect, any connection that can be accomplished by soldering various terminals together is the node, right? This is, for example, in here is the node. In practical circuit, electric circuit, yeah, right? We can also have supernode. Supernode means if we define the area across more than one element, and we can call this part as a supernode. Maybe it's circuit is a. We can analyze this supernode as a node in the circuit. Okay, I will show later on about supernode analysis. Okay. Here, right? Supernode can be treated in exactly the same way as node, right? For analysis, for the analysis. This is a node in practice, right? It's the junction of the branch, right? Here. Here is the node, right? In this case, so this, yes, so this is a node, right? Many branches connect together. Here also, this is the node, right? And then talk about the loop. The loop is at the closest connection of branch, right? Here we can have, for example, in this circuit, we can define loop 1, loop 2. This is the closed circuit. And then we can define loop 3 also, the loop. The loop can be inside the loop also. And for example, this circuit, we will have one loop. This circuit, we can define 1, 2, and 3 loop, right? This is loop number 3. So this circuit, we have 3 loop. Yeah. And for node, how many node of this circuit? How many node of this circuit? We have this first node, and this is second node. Here we have only 2 node, right? Node 1 and node 2. We have only 2 junction in case of this circuit, right? And how many node of this circuit? We have this 1, 2, 3, and 4, right? Here we have 4 node, node 1, node 2, node 3, and node 4, right? So to define the loop and node is really important when you go to the next slide. For next time, I will talk about node analysis and mesh analysis. Okay, come to the mesh definition. A mesh is a loop that does not contain other loop, right? The mesh is only closed part itself, is not contain any other loop or any other mesh, right? The mesh are an important aid to certain analysis method. So we have nodal analysis or node analysis. And we will have mesh analysis in next time. Okay. So this is the example of mesh. This circuit, we have 4 mesh. Mesh 1, mesh 2, mesh 3, mesh 4. In fact, mesh is the subset of the loop, right? Mesh is the subset of the loop. We can call this loop 1 also. And how many loop of this circuit? So many loop, right? We can have this loop. We can also have this loop. We can also have this loop. And also this loop, right? And this loop, so many loop in this circuit. But we have only 4 mesh, right? 4 mesh in this circuit. So node and mesh is very important concept for circuit analysis. Okay, now let's talk about the important laws of circuit analysis, which is the Kirchhoff-Kölin law. So in the section 2.2 in the textbook, the author also talk about the charge and Kölin. So I skip this part. So I come to Kirchhoff-Kölin laws. They have two important laws, is the Kirchhoff-Kölin law and Kirchhoff voltage laws, right? For Kirchhoff-Kölin law state that in order for Kölin to fall, there must exist a closed circuit, right? This must be a closed circuit that the Kölin flow. In other words, no Kölin or no charge is lost allow the closed circuit. All current must be flow in the closed path. No, the current flow out from the circuit in this case. So this principle was observed by the scientist named Kirchhoff and is known as Kirchhoff-Kölin laws or KCL. Okay. Okay, then KCL state that because charge cannot be created but must be conserved, the sum of current at a node must equal to zero. The sum of current at a node must equal to zero. Okay. Yeah, if we have the node, in this circuit we have two nodes, right? Node 1 and node 2, right? This is a junction of the battery and three lamps. So the current flow into the node must equal to the current flow out from the node, right? So in this case, we may define the size of current. So in this case, the current flow out is positive psi, and the current flow in will be negative psi. So minus I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus IT, or we can say I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, and then we can have this equation, or we can divide the sign in another way, right? The current flow into the node, if we define the current flow into the node as positive psi, the current flow out would be negative. Flow out is negative. Flow out is negative. We can also say this equation in another way, that I is I minus I1 minus I2 minus I3 equal to zero, right? Or we can use the general equation as a summation of In n equal to 1 until n equal to zero. This is the Kirchhoff current law. The summation of current is zero, okay? But be careful about the sign, positive and negative. This is an example of the electric circuit in the car, okay? For example, in the car, we have the battery, right? And the battery will supply the electric to many, many parts in the car, right? For example, to the headlamp, the tail lamp, start engine, fan, lock, and latch, for example, here. And the current flow from battery will equal to the current flow from battery will equal to all current flow to the device in the car system. Okay, so we connect the load in parallel, right? In this case, the load is connect in parallel. This is, we can use the node Kirchhoff current laws to analyze this circuit, right? Okay, let's see some example with calculation to apply the KCL. So this problem states that to determine the unknown current in the circuit, right? And the known quantity is 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 5 amp. In this case, for if we have the ammeter here, we can measure this IS 5 ampere. And I1 is 2 ampere. I1 here is 2 ampere. This is the known variable. It means that maybe we have measurement divide here, right? This is 2 ampere. And I2 is negative 3 ampere. Negative minus 3 ampere. Or on the other hand, the current flow in different direction, right? With 3 ampere, with positive 3 ampere here. And I3 is 0.5 amp. I3 is 0.5 amp. 1.5 ampere. Yeah, okay. So with the KCL, we can easily compute IO, right? And I4 here, because we know that IO plus I1 plus I2 must equal to zero, right? Here we just apply KCL to this node. So we can compute IO as 1 ampere, right? To make the KCL with this node, right? And then for node B, similarly, we can compute I4, the unknown value. I4 is the IS. In this case, IS is flowing in, right? If in this case, IS flowing in is positive, the flowing out is negative. I4 also negative, right? IS is 5, I3 is 1.5, and I4, negative I4, equal to 0. So I4 is 3.5. Yeah, okay. This is an example for KCL, right? It's not so difficult now. Then we can also apply the KCL to supernode also. Yeah, right? So apply KCL to the circuit in the figure 2.14 using concept of supernode to determine the source of S1, so to determine the S1. S1 is flowing into this circuit right here. And we know I3 is 2 ampere, I5 is 0, right? There's no current flow here. I3 is 2 ampere flowing out, 2 ampere, and I5 is 0 ampere here. Okay, then with supernode, the current flow into supernode must be equal to the current flow out from supernode. Okay, KCL. KCL can also be applied to supernode also, right? So in this case, if we define the current flow into supernode in is positive sign and flow out is negative sign. Therefore, IS1 minus I3 minus I5 is 0, right? We can form this equation. Then we just substitute I3 to 2 ampere and I5 0 ampere. Then we found that IS is 2 ampere, right? Okay, this is the concept of KCL. Just be careful the sign and the direction of the current. This is very, very important when you make the analysis, right? Flowing in and flowing out of the node. Okay. Now let's talk about the KVL of Kirchhoff voltage laws, right? The KVL state that the net voltage around the closed circuit is 0. The net voltage around the closed circuit is 0. If you sum this voltage to this voltage to this voltage, it would be 0 for the circuit. So the summation of Vn, n equal to 1 to capital N is equal to 0. This is the Kirchhoff voltage law here. For example, if you have only two elements, so V1 and V2 must be equal, right? Because we have only two devices in this circuit. For example, if you build the KVL loop, right? If you the current flow from positive, right? Positive V1, and the current flow from in this equipment, the current flow from negative V2, right? Here, equal to 0 in this case. So finally, we have V1 equal to V2 here. This is the Kirchhoff voltage law. So for convenient analysis, we should define the reference voltage in practice, right? In the analysis method, usually we define one node as a reference voltage. In this case, if we define VB here, the voltage at node B as a reference here, and then we have VB equal to 0 as a reference. All voltage in this circuit will compare to VB. For example, then V1 is 1.5 volt here. V2 is VA minus VB, right? VA minus VB, and VB is 0. So VA is 1.5 also. So we found that V2 equal to VA here. V2 and VA is equal because VB is 0 when we make VB as a reference voltage. And usually reference voltage, sometimes we call ground voltage. It's ground point of the circuit here. Okay. The concept of reference voltage defined in practice used in the ground voltage of the circuit. Okay. Yeah. And the ground symbol, you can write this symbol as a ground of. Sometimes this symbol is also used. Okay. And it is convenient to assign a potential of 0 volt to the ground voltage reference. All voltage in the circuit mean the voltage comparative to the ground. Okay. This is the example of Kirchhoff current laws in the electric vehicle battery packs. So in the electric car or EV, right? In EV. Electric vehicle, we could have the a lot of battery connect together, right, to increase the volt of the battery. The battery have only 12 volt, but to drive the motor we may need the higher voltage. So in this case the battery will be connected with in series circuit, right, in series circuit. So battery 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will connect in series. In this case, there is 31 battery packs. Okay, here, yeah. Battery number V bat number 31, right? In this case, and the outcome voltage from the battery packs will be the sum of all battery voltage together, right? Here, yeah, in this case, so we have battery 1, 2, 3 until battery 31 connected to the electric drive of the motor. This is the electric circuit, right, to drive the motor, to control the speed of the motor of the car. Yeah. So in this case, the summation of all battery equal to the voltage to drive the motor, right here. This is V drive, right, or this is V drive here. And okay, and next we look into some example of KVL in calculation. So okay, so in this problem we have this circuit, right? In this circuit we have the voltage source VS2 and we have the element which have the voltage across is as V1 and V2 here and V3 here. And we know that Vs is 12 volt. We know this value, and we know V1 is 6 volt. In this case, if we have the volt meter, we measure this volt as 6 volt, and V3 is 1 volt. If we have the volt meter, and then we measure the voltage of this element, and we got 1 voltage, and we have this 6 voltage, so we can compute V2 right here. And then how to form the KVL in this case. Okay, so in this case I myself, when I form KVL, I use this sign. So if we create the loop, here, right, the loop flow from positive sign, and the loop flow from negative sign, and from negative sign, and from negative sign here. So then we have plus VS2, right? I have plus VS2 and minus V1, minus V1 and minus V2, and then minus V3 equal to 0. This is KVL equation for this circuit, right? So we have this equation, right? VS2 minus V1 minus V2 minus V3 equal to 0, because KVL state that summation of VN N01 to capital N, number of element is 0, right? But be careful about the sign of the voltage, right? Here. Then we can substitute VS1 is 12, V1 is 6, and V3 is 1. We can easily compute V2, and we have got V2 of 5 volt. So V2 is 5 volt to make the to provide KVL for this circuit, right? So any question so far? Not too fast. If I go too fast, you can
not fast. Okay. It's okay.
It's okay. Okay. Right. Too slow and make you sleepy. I don't know. Okay. Come to another problem. For example, if we apply KVL to determine the unknown voltage V1 and V4. In this case, we want to look for V1 and V4. Yeah, V4. And what we know is, in this case, we know VS1 is 12, right? 12 volt. VS2 minus 1, minus 4 volt. V2 is 2 volt. V2 is 2 volt. And V3 is 6 volt. 6 volt. V5, 12 volt. Okay. Then let's make a loop then, okay, to determine the voltage, the unknown voltage is V1 and V4. So we know this voltage and this voltage. So this is the best way is to make this loop, right? To compute this loop. So I will draw the loop first. Here, this is the loop. Our first loop. Okay. So to create equation for this loop, so Vs is positive, right? You remember Vs is positive. Vs1, then what? Minus V1, minus V1, minus V2, and then minus V3 equal to 0. So this is the first equation here. And then we know Vs is 12, V1 we don't know. And V2 is 2 volt, V3 is 6 volt, so we can easily compute V1 here. We can compute V1 at 4 volt, okay. Now V1 is 4 volt, we know. Next, let's see the loop to compute V4. So we can compute V4 from this loop also. Maybe this loop is also, you can get V4 from this loop. You can also get V4 from this loop, right? Or this loop also. So many loop you can do it. So I will try to use this loop. Check for this loop, right? So for this loop, we have negative Vs, positive V2, positive V4, positive V2, right? So minus VS2 plus V4 and plus V2 must be 0. It's maybe this equation, right? It's similar to this equation. Then we can substitute VS2 as 4 volt. So in this case, minus of minus 4 volt plus V4, we don't know V4, and then V2 is 2 voltage, V2 equal to 0, so we can get V4 equal to how much? Minus 6 volt. Minus 6. Okay, here. Okay. V5 is 12 volt. Why we don't need this equation? Because we know that. Okay. Maybe some area of this problem. Okay. Okay, V4. Oh, sorry, VS2, not V4, right? Oh, V4. V4 is minus 6. Okay, it's okay. Minus 6. Okay. What mean by this voltage source of minus 4 volt? It means that, in fact, the voltage is in opposite side, right? It's plus minus is here for VS2 and it's positive V4. You can draw this symbol instead of this symbol with minus 4. You can draw this symbol with positive 4 volt, right? It's equal together to each other. Okay. Okay. We have talked about KCL, KVL, and you know about node and mesh. Node and mesh, right? And you also know about supernode. And you also know about loop, right? And with node, we can use KCL to node and to supernode also. We can also use KVL to mesh and loop also, right? Yeah, so far. And next slide, we talk the node and mesh analysis in detail, right? Right. For slide 3, okay. Anyway, let's talk it later for node and mesh analysis. Okay, now let's talk about the electric power and sine convention. The power is defined as the work in over the time, right? And the work divided by the charge, and the charge divided by the time. The work for the charge means voltage. The charge flow during the time we call the current, right? Or in electric power, we can compute the power generated by the active element by P or the power equal to voltage into current. P is V into I, right? Multiply with I here. This is the power generated by the active element. Active element means source, right? From the source, from the battery, from the generator, is equal to the power dissipated or consumed or stored in the passive element in the resistor, for example, and is equal to the product of volt across the element and the current flow through it, right? So in case it is the power dissipated, right? Here. The the power generated, for example, if this is the active circuit, right? For active circuit, the current will flow from the positive side here in this case, and the power would be voltage into I for active element. And but for the power dissipated circuit, or this is the passive circuit, right? Here, passive circuit, the current is flow into the positive side. So in this case, the power consumed by this circuit is V into I. Here, this is positive, and this is positive for power generation. This is positive for power dissipated. Dissipated means consumed or uses, power uses. And it is important to realize that just like voltage, power is a sine qualitative, and it is necessary to make the distinction between positive and negative power, okay, as I discussed before, right? is dependent on the power is consumed or the power is generated. In case of negative generation, mean it's consumed the power, right? Or the negative consuming power is mean it's generate the power, similar to the current flow and the voltage across each element also here. So the power dissipated by the load is positive quantity, or is generate the negative quantity, we can say in another word, right? And the power generated by the source is positive, right? The source will generate the positive power generation, or is consume the negative value of power on the other hand, okay? Just the some positive and negative manner. This may make you confused, right? When we analyze some circuit, we don't know that circuit is active or passive. If we just start with it is a passive circuit, but when we compute the current it flow out from that circuit, so it's become the active circuit, for example. So the direction of current and voltage and the power is very important. Okay. So in this example, so use of the passive sign convention. So apply the passive sign convention to the circuit here. The known quantity is the voltage across each circuit element. If we know the voltage across each circuit, so the battery will supply to load number one and load number two here, right? Find the power dissipated or generated by each element here. So in case the current will flow in this direction, right? Yeah, and the current flow into the load is plus and minus, and this is plus and minus for voltage, and the current flow this direction I. Here the current flow from this direction. Power generated by this circuit is by the battery is VB into I, right? And the power generated by the load is I plus negative. It's negative V load 1 into I. Or in this case, is consume V load and I. Okay. Here, this is just the example for the passive sign convention. Okay. Similar for this load, right? It will consume the power. Okay. This is the detail that for analyze this circuit, right? So assume the clockwise direction of current flow. We can do both method, right? We can assume the current it flow clockwise, or the current flow counterclockwise as well here. So for the current flow in clockwise here, this loop VB is 12 volt, V1 is 8 volt, and V2 is 4 volt. How can we know V1 and V2? Because this is available in the equation, right? And the current of the circuit is 0.1 amp. Okay, the current is 0.1 ampere here. Okay, so if we use the clockwise direction for the current flow, P of the battery, the current flow here, right, is minus VB into I, is minus 1.2 watt. In this case, we define the power dissipated is positive. If the device consumes the power, okay, if the device consume power, the sign is positive. Okay, yeah. So for the battery, it consume the power of minus 1.2. In fact, it means that it generate the power, right? Generate 1.2 watts in this case, right? and for load 1, load 1 is voltage 8 volt into 0.1 amp. Load 2 is 4 into 0.1 amp. Load 1 is 8 watt and load 2 is 0.8 watt and load 2 is 0.4 watt. So in this case it's positive, so it means it's used or it's consumed. 0.8 and 0.4 watt respectively. Okay. Yeah. We can also have the counterclockwise method, right? In this case, the voltage is negative 12 and this is negative 8 and this is also negative 4 here. Yeah. And we can compute in similar way. We will found that the battery will consume minus power, right? Negative power is mean it's generate the power and for the load 1 and 2 in similar way. Okay. Okay, just a last problem before I make a break, right? I think you need some break now. I don't know, but maybe after 1 hour we can have some break, right? Okay, for the circuit show in the figure 2.25, so this figure, right? Determine which component are absorbing power, which component is absorb the power, and which is delivering power. So which one use the power, right, or consume the power, or which one generate the power? Which one consume the power? Yeah, is conservation of power satisfy? Explain the answer. Okay, current through element D and E. We know the current flow and the voltage across B, C, E here, right? So we know this voltage, we know this current, we know this voltage, and we know this current, we know this voltage here. Okay. Then first, apply KCL, the current through the element B is 5 amp, right? We know this is 2 ampere, this is 3 ampere here. So this current flow is 5 ampere, right? Here. Computed from these two current. And then to derive by KVL. By KVL, we apply KVL to this loop, right? VA. With this loop, right? Because we know this is 3 volt, 10 volt, and 5 volt here. Okay, then in this case, minus would be here, right? Minus and plus Vs we define here, and negative minus and plus this is plus and minus, or we can have plus V3 plus V3 plus 3 volt minus 10, right? Minus 10 and then minus 5 equal to 0, or we can write down minus V3 minus 3 plus 10 and plus 5 equal to 0. Both are the same, right? And for this equation, and we can have VA is 12 volt here. Yeah. Now let's compute the power of each element. So in this case, the current flow from the positive terminal of element A. So this element is the delivering power, right? It's generate the power. Yeah. So A supply supply the power or deliver the power for 12 multiplied with 5, right, is 60 watt supply from A. And for B, B, the current flow from positive terminal also, B is 3 into 5 is 12 watt. So B also supply the voltage, the power of 15 watt here, right? So A should be battery. B also should be battery here. How about C? The current flow here is 3 and 2 and 5 amp. The current flow into the positive terminal of C, right? Therefore, C absorb the power, right? So C dissipate the power or absorb the power for 5 into 5, right? 5 amp. 5 amp and 5 volt, so therefore 25 watt here. And how about D? D, the voltage across D is equal to the voltage across E, right? Because it is the same node here, and this is the same node here. So the voltage across D is 10 volt plus minus, and the current flow into D is 3 ampere. So D absorb the power of 30 watt here, right? And E also absorb the power of 2 ampere into 10 volt, so it's 20 watt here. Okay, now we have this value. So total power supply to this circuit, so we have two battery, right? This is the battery, and this is the battery, and this should be resistor, and resistor, and resistor, right? It's a passive device and active device. The resistor is passive, and the battery is active, right? Active device and passive device here. Okay. The total power supply to the circuit is 60 and 15, right? Its total is 75 watt. And the total power consumed from the passive device is 25, 30 and 20, and it's also 20 watt. So this the convention of power is satisfied, right? The conservation, sorry, the power conservation rule is satisfied. Okay, the conservation rule of power. The supply and absorb power are equal, right? Okay, so I leave this page to you to check your own understanding, right? You just read this slide and try to check your understanding, and the answer is here, right? The answer is here. Just try to do by yourself, make understanding by yourself, and checking your understanding by turn around this page. You can see the answer, right? Okay. So I will stop here, and maybe you need some.
Sorry, teacher.